can solve the problem of that was arises in the producer consumer scenario. So let us start this critical section. As the word suggests you, critical means what? Critical means what? Can anyone tell me what is the meaning of critical? Critical means what? Yes, any synonym you can tell. What is the meaning of critical? Anyone? Come on. Section, you are aware that section is something kind area, right? Problem is your problem. And so what is this critical? Come on, give some synonyms for this word critical. Soft.
सर आलोचक आलोचक
बेटा, थिंक अबाउट इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट. Otherwise, one this word is having different meaning in different context. Now you are having this critical word in which particular context? In this producer consumer problem. So think in that direction. Otherwise, one word have a different meaning in different context. Like you are someone saying rare, soft, and alochak kind of thing. Like film critics, if you are talking about film critics, then your answer is correct. That critics are those who are criticized, something like that. Now here, this critical thing is something else. Yeah, serious, necessary, analytical,
क्रूशियल
crucial. Yes. Have you heard somewhere that health of this patient is very critical? Now tell me, what is the meaning of critical in this context? Health of this patient is very critical. We have to take him to the ICU right now,
नाजुक
right? What? Nazuk means
नाजुक
give. I understand.
सीरियस सर
Serious. Okay. So, are you understand that what we are talking about, that this patient is in very critical situation? We have to take him to the ICU right now, right? So this is the thing. We are talking about that the situation right now the patient is in, this is very critical one, means anything can happen to this guy if we have not take care of this patient right now, understand? So this is the thing here, the critical section problem means we are dealing with an area of a code which is very critical in nature. Means if you means delicate in nature, if you are not able to monitor or process that code in a proper manner, then anything can happen, just like that patient which is in very critical situation. Now you understand what is the context and what is the meaning of this critical in this area? Yes or no? Did you got the answer? Critical means yes. Everyone? Okay, so this is the thing. The thing is, we have to first understand what we are try to understand and what we are going to study. If we are very clear in our thoughts that this is the thing we will study today, and this is the context of this problem, then whatever I will told you in next slides, in my lecture, then you can relate those things that what we are talking about. Means what is the background of this discussion that we are having, and how we can relate those things to the real world. If you are able to connect those things, then you are good to go. Okay, so now we will discuss the critical section problem, and we have to relate these things to that producer consumer problem also. So you have to think a lot of things in today's class. You have to relate producer consumer problem, you have to understand what I am telling you, and you have to relate those things to the real world also. So be concentrate on these things, and then you will get everything that I want to understand to all of you. Okay, so let's start the critical section problem. Firstly, we will discuss what is the critical section, then we will discuss that how we can solve this problem. Okay, so the critical section problem. What is a critical section? Critical section is something whenever we are having some cooperating processes which are sharing resources, right? So when we are sharing resources, then what will happen? Either we are updating any files or we are updating any common variable, just like that counter variable in producer consumer problem. So if we are updating a common variable, then there is always a risk that another concurrent process may also wants to update that common variable, right? So this is the critical situation. This is the critical area where we are updating a common shared variable. So we have to take care this area. So what is written here that we are talking about in general that there are n number of processes in a system, then each process has a segment of code. What we are talking about a critical section segment of code in which process may be either changing the common variables. Changing means updating the common variable, updating a table, writing a file and so on. Anything means whatever we are doing on common things like shared things with other processes, only then we term that as region which is having the code which is updating the common variables. Just like I give you an example that in your house, if you have five members and you are having only single television and you are having a single remote for that. Now, if your father is watching TV right now, then means he is using that remote thing, remote which is used to change the channels of your TV, and he is in its critical section, right? So if you are trying to manipulate the channel, then what will happen? There is a clash, right? And the father is watching the TV, he is watching the news or something else, and you are trying to do something else, then there is a clash, then there is an issue with you and the father who is watching the TV. So we have to be really delicate and take care of this situation that if father is watching the TV right now, that no one will be allowed to watch the TV, right? But what there is a scenario, suppose father is watching the TV whole day, whole night, then what about four other member of your house? Will they able to watch the TV for that day? This is not a very good situation that only one resource is using by your father whole day, whole night, 24 hours he is taking the remote in his hand, and four other members of your house is not able to watch the TV. So there must be a cap that after how much time another person can watch the TV, right? Understand? And in 24 hours, all the five members of your house may get some share of your TV that they can watch something. Means they can progress in the area that they can watch at least 30 minutes, 1 hour, right? So these are the things we have to take care in this. So let's see in this system, what is written? Consider a system consisting of n processes, P0, P1, Pn minus 1. Each process has a segment of code called critical section, in which the process may be changing common variables, updating a table, writing a file, and so on. So let's have this discussion in a code format. Every code is having four sections. First one is entry section. An entry section is that which where we declare some variables or some like printf, please enter some value kind of thing, means that has nothing to do with common variables. But where you are updating the common shared memory area, which is comes under the critical section. And then we have an exit section, means from exit section means like we are exiting from this critical section. And then remainder section. Remainder section is what? Those independent like printf that have nothing to do with the critical section, right? So this, when you are updating your common variable which comes under the critical section. So there are four things: entry section, critical section, exit section, and remainder section. In entry section, what we will do? Normal things like independent statement that have nothing to do with the other process. But then we have a critical section in which we are updating a common variable which is shared by other processes. And then we have to exit from this critical section. And then what we are having? We are having again those independent statements that have nothing to do with concurrent processes. Means there is nothing we are updating in shared memory area, because everything we are updating in critical section, that comes under this critical section only. So what are the four things we are having? Entry section, critical section, then exit section, and remainder section. Okay, so whenever this question come in your examination, you have to define the critical section problem, then this code you have to be write into the examination so that you can get good marks. So what is the specialty or the feature of this critical section? As I told you, that if your father is watching TV, then no one else will be allowed to watch the TV right that time. Means watch the TV in the sense you cannot take the remote at that time. If this is the time of your father to watch the news for 1 hour, then no other member of your house will be allowed to take the remote and change the channel, right? This is the thing. Now I'm giving you this example so that you can relate those things with this operating system thing, that suppose one process is executing something and no other process will be allowed to interrupt that process and start executing. So here what is written? The important feature of the system is that when one process is executing in its critical section, no other process is allowed to execute in its critical section. This is the crux. And this is the crux of critical section, and related with producer-consumer problem also. The problem arises when both the processes are updating that counter variable at a time, then there was an issue. As you have seen, that why to update a counter variable in machine code, we are having three statements, right? In that was assembly language code, we are having three statements. That firstly, you have to put the counter value into a register. Then we are updating the register 1 equal to register 1 plus 1, right? And then you have to assign that register value to again that memory cell of counter. So we have seen in previous lecture that producer has executed two statements, but before executing its third statement, that another consumer process comes into the picture and it has started executing its statement of first and second. And then there was an issue, because in between that process comes into the picture and it was updating that counter variable simultaneously. So this is the solution they have find out, that stop other process, let first finish its execution of all that three statements at one go, and then allow that consumer process, okay, come, this is your turn now. So this is the important feature of the system, that when process is executing in its critical section, no other process is allowed to execute in its critical section. Now, what are the other features that we have to take care? As I told you, that suppose your father is taking the remote 24 hours, then what about other four members of your family, how they can watch the TV, right? So there must be a cap that how much time father can watch the news, right? So let's see what are the other cases that we have to consider to solve this critical section problem. So what is the solution to this critical section? A solution to the critical section problem must satisfy the following three requirements. Now we have designed three requirements that must be fulfilled to solve this critical section problem, and we can justify our answer, whatever we have designed to solve that problem, that okay, if these three requirements are satisfied, then we can say that our problem is solved. First one is mutual exclusion. Mutual exclusion is what we will discuss in next slide, and then progress, and then bounded waiting. So what is the meaning of mutual exclusion? What is the meaning of progress, and what is the meaning of bounded waiting? Let's see one by one. Firstly, we will pick mutual exclusion. Now, mutual exclusion is what? Let's have another example. Suppose this example is for what? Mutual exclusion is what? That if one process is executing, no other process will allow to execute at that time. Let's have an example of your university. Suppose like who are in the, like suppose there are Chitranshu and Abhishek, right? And they both wants to drink the water, and they have taken the permission from the teacher and have gone to the water cooler for drinking the water, right? Now, suppose Chitranshu is drinking the water right now, but Rohit also wants to drink the water, but he has to wait until and unless Chitranshu has completed drinking the water, right? Is it a good manner that if you push Chitranshu and then drink the water, that I am more thirsty, I want to drink water as you are taking more time? And this is not a good manner, right? So you have to wait. Rohit has to wait until and unless Chitranshu drink the water. So where Chitranshu is right now, he is in its critical section. He is in his critical section means he is drinking the water, and that water is also was to be drink by the Rohit also, but he has to wait until and unless Chitranshu is completed drinking the water. So what is mutual exclusion? So here in the form of operating system, let's see. If a process PI, you can think that I is a counter that can vary from 0 to N minus 1. So if a process P is executing in its critical section, then no other process can be executing in their critical section. Means if Chitranshu is drinking water right now, Rohit will not be allowed to drink the water at the same time, because there is only one tap in water cooler and only one person can drink the water at a time, right? Are we clear with this mutual exclusion? Yes or no? Pretty easy this, that no, if one is in its critical section, no other process can be executed in its critical section. Are we good with this mutual exclusion? Exclusion means you have to be excluded with others, right? So please write in the chat box, are we good with this mutual exclusion, first property? Yes or no? Okay, so that was the pretty simple one. And you can think about that, your example also that I have given you, that if Chitranshu is drinking the water right now, Rohit will not be allowed to drink the water at the same time. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Okay. Good. I think you want to write good. You have written God. Okay, no issue. So let's move on the second one. Progress. Okay, so what is the progress? Now, suppose there are 50 students in our class, right? And that Chitranshu and Rohit, those who have gone for drinking the water, have drink the water and come back to our classroom. And now these two students have drink the water, they are good. Now what about 48 other students? They also thirsty because in hot summer, everyone wants to drink the water and they are not having the bottles with them. Just kidding. So what I want to tell you, that what is the progress? That those 48 students who are remaining, that only will decide who will go next to drink the water. Are you able to understand? Suppose there are 50 students in our classroom, right? Two students have already drink the water. They are not interested in drinking the water again. So who are interested in drinking the water? Rest 48 students in our class, those who are remaining, they are pretty much interested in drinking the water. Now, those 48 students will decide who will go next to drink the water, right? Because everyone is saying, I want to go to drink the water. Everyone is raising his hand. Then there must be a mechanism to decide who will go next to drink the water. So this is what? Progress, because in progress we have to give water to each and every resources, each and every process that is there in our classroom. These are 48 students, these are the processes, and they want to drink the water, means they want to have the resources of operating system, right? So in this manner you can relate those things. So let's see what is the progress. If no process is executing in its critical section, if no process, I told you that water cooler is free now, means no one is drinking the water right now. Please keep relating those things, and these things are very easy. And what is the first line? Move with me very slowly and you will understand each and everything. I will explain each and everything to you. very clearly. You don't have to mug anything. You have to just relate these things with your real world, and you can write each and everything in your words, and I will give you full marks in those things. Because this is what I want you students to have in you, that you can write these things without mugging and with the understanding of what we are studying right now. So if no process is executing in its critical section, means our water cooler is free right now. No one is standing there to wants to drink the water. It means operating that CPU is free right now. Now what will happen? Go on the next line. And some processes wish to enter their critical section. Now, who are those processes? Relate to our example, those 48 students, because two have already drank the water. Now, those 48 students wish to enter their critical section, means they wish to go to drink the water, right? So far, so good. Let's move next line. Then, only those processes that are not executing in their remainder section. Now, to whom we are talking about? Those two students who have already drank the water, they are in their remainder section, right? So they will not decide who will go next to drink the water. They have already finished their critical section. So what is written here? Then only those processes that are not executing in their remainder section can participate in deciding which process will enter its critical section next. Means who is going to decide? Those 40 students who wish to enter their critical section, means those who wish to drink the water. And those two students who have already drank the water will not participate in this exercise because they are already in their remainder section, means they have already drank the water and they are good. Now, what is the next line? And this selection cannot be postponed indefinitely. Means those 48 students have the responsibility to decide which process will go next to drink the water. But you have such a mechanism that no process has to wait indefinitely. Means something that each 48 students will get a fair chance to go and drink the water. This is what the requirement of this is. Progress means each and every process will have a fair chance to progress, means they cannot be blocked indefinitely. So are we good with this characteristics of progress? Did you get the crux that who will decide to go next to drink the water? Those who are not in their remainder section. They will decide with some mechanism. That mechanism may be differ with other problems we will discuss. But the thing is, we have to have some mechanism with which those processes which wish to enter their critical section will decide who will go next to drink the water, and that selection in such a manner that no process left behind in this manner that they have to wait endlessly, right? So this is the requirement of progress. Are we good with this progress? Yes or no? Did you get the example which I gave you? Please explain the last line again. Okay, so I'm again telling you, what is the last line? Thus, Adarsh is saying no. Okay, I'm again, he is having some network issue. I'm again explaining this progress one. Firstly, I will explain from first line so that you can have a fair understanding. So what is the thing of progress? Now, I have given you an example that we are having 50 students in our class, right? And we have seen that Chitranshu and Rohit had already drank the water and they have come back to our class. And now 48 students, they also wish to go to drink the water. Now, we operating system has the responsibility that all these 48 students have a fair chance to go and drink the water. Who is operating system in the classroom? I am. Means teacher is the operating system. I am the resource manager. This is my responsibility to have a mechanism so that all the 48 students can have a fair chance to go to drink the water. Now, how I will implement this mechanism? As I have seen that two students have already drank the water, right? Now, only those 48 students, those who have not drank the water right now, they can go and drink the water. But how we will do some mechanism that these 48 students will vote that, okay, who will go next? Adarsh will go next. That these 48 students who are remaining, who wish to go to drink the water, they do some, suppose I am giving an example, they do vote that who will go next. Suppose they vote for Adarsh, that okay, Adarsh will go to drink the water. So in this manner, there is a voting keep going. That okay, Adarsh is going, then Priyam is going, then Soumya is going. And in this manner, there must be not any left out student. Means no process can wait or postpone indefinitely. Means everyone have a fair chance to go to drink the water. Means everyone have a fair chance to go through process in the CPU in a fair manner. So you cannot wait indefinitely. As I give you an example, that suppose Priyam has gone for drinking the water and he is not coming back. Just like your father is watching the TV 24 hours. Now all other four members are still waiting when we will get the chance. Similarly, Priyam has gone for drinking the water and he is just drinking the water. He is having some supernatural power, I guess. And he is drinking the water for 24 hours. And what about others? Priyam, are you having some supernatural power? To drink the water endlessly?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. So just imagine that Priyam is having a supernatural power and he can drink as much water as he wants. So he has gone from the classroom to drink the water. Now he is drinking water. He is keep drinking the water. Now other students who are waiting in the classroom, that when Priyam will come from by once drinking the water, we will decide who will go next. So this is a thing of progress. Now you understand what is a progress? In progress, each and every process has to have a fair chance to drink the water. Yes or no? So that we will move on next one. Did you got? Okay. So very pretty things, straightforward things, that what was the mutual exclusion? If Chitranshu is drinking the water, Rohit was not allowed to drink the water. Yes. What was the progress? In progress, we have a mechanism through which each and every process has a fair chance to go to drink the water. And if some process has to wait to go to the CPU, they cannot be wait endlessly, means indefinitely. This post that we postpone, that okay, just wait that Rohit will come, then you can go. So you are postponing that person Priyam to go to the water once Rohit come back, right? So this postpone that you are postponing that Priyam to wait that Rohit will come, so that cannot be done indefinitely. So this is what progress. Now what is the last one? Last one was bounded waiting. Let's see what is a bounded waiting. As the name suggests, that what we are talking about, that I given you that if one process is executing in its critical section, then what about others? They must be have some timeline that after which time Rohit will allow to go to drink the water. So let's see what is a bounded waiting. There exists a bound. Bound means a limit. Bound means what? A limit on the number of times that other processes are allowed to enter their critical section. After a process has made a request to enter its critical section and before that request is granted. So what is bounded waiting? Excuse me. There exists a bound or limit on the number of times that other processes are allowed to enter their critical section. Means if one process is executing right now, then another process, there must be a limit on that, that after how much time that process can be allowed to go to in its critical section. And in this manner, we can have a bounded waiting kind of thing. Means bounded means there must be a limit that after how much time you that another process can execute in their critical section. Means they cannot wait indefinitely. So this is what bounded waiting, that there must be a cap that after how much time or number of times next process can enter in its critical section. Excuse me. Okay. So there exists a bound, means a limit on the number of times that other processes are allowed to enter their critical section. after a process has made a request to enter in its critical section, and before that request is granted. Means you have requested to go, you wants to go to the drinking the water, right? You requested the teacher, sir, I wants to go to drink the water. And sir have some mechanism on which basis he is deciding that Soumya will go to drink the water or not, and when Soumya will go to drink the water. So that mechanism which is deciding that Soumya, who is requesting to go to drink the water, and the resource person, that is your operating system, that is a teacher, who is thinking in his mind that if shall I let Soumya go to drink the water. So this is the gap. What is written here? Once a request is made to enter its critical section, Soumya has requested to go to drink the water, and before that request is granted. And before that request is granted means before I allow Soumya to go to drink the water. So there must be a bound or number of times that who can go to drink the water and how many number of times. Suppose Chitranshu is again and again wants to go to drink the water. So how can other resources, can processes can get the chance to drink the water? So there must be a bound. So let's discuss all these three things, mutual exclusion, progress and bounded waiting, in a form of diagram. You can better understand. Let's see. Suppose here is a process A. At time T1, it process A enter in its critical section. Process A enter in its critical section at time T1. Now from T1 to T3, this process is executing, and at time T3, process A leaves its critical section, right? Process A leaves its critical section. Now process B is also comes concurrently, and what will happen? At time T2, process B wants to go in its critical section, but operating system has blocked process B, because right now process A in its critical section, right? Process A is in a critical section. So B attempts to enter critical region. So operating system blocked this process. B is blocked at how much time B is blocked? Till time T3, process B is blocked. And once process A leaves the critical section, process B entered in its critical section, and at T4, B leaves critical region. So now you have very fair idea that Chitranshu is drinking the water from T1 to time T3. At time T2, which is less than time T3, Rohit comes, he wants to drink the water, but Rohit is blocked because Chitranshu is drinking the water till time T3. And once Chitranshu leaves at time T3, then only Rohit will be allowed to enter in its critical section, means to be allowed to you drink the water. And then Rohit also leaves at time T4. So this is the solution they have proposed to solve the critical section where we are updating a common variables. Very common sense thing that you have to block another process if you are updating a common variable. Understand? So this is the things we have discussed today. Keep revising these things. We will discuss some other concept of this second unit in next class. Okay, I will upload today's class lecture note in Google Classroom. So bye bye, keep learning.